And now, a countdown of the top 10 dumbest hecklers getting owned. Since the theme of this countdown is being a dummy, I thought it might be a good time to give a shout out to Audible. Why Audible? Because books help you be less of a dummy. Also, this channel has now grown big enough that we've actually gotten a sponsor. See this cool set behind me? That is thanks to Audible, which is the largest library of audiobooks on the planet, and also on other planets, because they don't have audiobooks yet. I am assuming my book Ginger Kid is available there. If you haven't read it yet, go do that. Actually, on Audible, I'll read it to you. I gotta say, the process of recording an audiobook was super weird. It was a couple of days reading my own book while the director told me I wasn't sounding enough like me. But I'm me! It was also weird because she was right. Anyway, when you're a member of Audible, you can choose 3 titles a month. You can get started with a 30-day trial of Audible when you go to audible.com/Hofstetter, or you text Hofstetter to 500-500. 3 titles a month. In case you missed it and you don't want to rewind, that is audible.com/Hofstetter or texting Hofstetter to 500-500. And now, let's get to the countdown. Number 10, Birthday Girl Heckler Gets Shut Down.
Queen's official motto is embarrassing. Do you know Queen's official motto?
You can't drive.
No, that's not it, but I wrote a punchline of the joke, and here's mine. Queen's official motto is not you can't drive. That'd be weird and accusatory of Queens.
I live in Queens.
You what?
I live in Queens, but I can't drive.
You live in Queens and you can't drive, so Queens' motto must be all about you. Because the whole fucking show's been, so why not Queens?
Number 9. Dr. Heckler owned.
Why did you boo New Jersey? Have you lived there?
No, I lived in New York.
You lived in New York? So you love New York that you would boo New Jersey. You love New York so much that you moved the fuck down here. I love it so much that I would like to live 7 states away. And where do you live now?
On 14th Street.
On 14th Street, so right here.
Yeah.
So boo the fuck out of 15th Street then. Jersey's done with you. There's no rivalry anymore. Where in New York did you live?
Westchester County.
You didn't even live in New York City. Boo in Jersey like you're from fucking Brooklyn or some shit. Be like, boo, New York represent. Meantime, the New Yorkers are like, where the fuck are you from? Westchester County is just East Jersey. That's all it is. Oh, I'm so terribly wrong. I'm kidding. Your mini malls are way different than Jersey's mini malls. Your diners, Jersey's diners, your mini golf, Jersey's mini golf. In fact, you're totally different because you have a different fucking letter in your state name, and that makes it okay to boo other places. Here's the thing, I'm gonna boo Jersey because I fucking have to live there. Wait, what did you just say while you were texting? You can't talk shit while you're texting unless someone's sending you notes. You're like, what should I say? Boo? Boo! What were you saying there, Smurf?
Binghamton.
You were talking shit about Binghamton? About some people from Binghamton who were...
Birthday girl.
Oh, birthday girl is from Binghamton?
Yeah.
Well, thank you for bringing that up. Because I was sitting here being like, you know what, this isn't enough. I'd like to bring Binghamton into the mix. And where are you from, Miss Tech? Stop fucking texting! Do you have a child at home?
No. I'm a doctor.
You're a doctor. And you're texting a patient right now?
Liar!
You're texting... Okay, first of all, even if she is a doctor, that's gotta be the worst fucking care I've ever seen anyone give. I'm having a heart attack. Happy face. Not texting shit. Don't even. You're a doctor? What are you a doctor of? No. I got this one, man. What are you? What is it that you're a doctor of? A what? A doctor of law? You're a fucking lawyer! Were you solving a case? I'm sorry, were you healing a case? Once you get called out, just fucking own your shit. You're texting, you're making fun of Binghamton, you know? I'd ask you where you're from, but I don't fucking believe. I can't believe anything you say. What?
Bergen County, New Jersey.
Bergen County, New Jersey. And you're proud.
Yes.
Good for you for being proud of Bergen County and making fun of Binghamton. Honey, she just bailed you the fuck out. I'm all about Westchester now. So you're from Bergen County, New Jersey. Where in Bergen County? I mean, I know.
Demarest.
What?
Demarest.
I do not know. That actually sounds like a condition that one of your patients might have. If you were a fucking doctor. You're a lawyer. Why can't you just say lawyer? You're a doctor of law? I've never even heard. It's not as good as saying doctor. Yeah, it's 4 years not as good of graduate school. I'm a fucking doctor of comedy. Can't just pretend to be a doctor. People pay money for that shit. What kind of law do you heal? You're looking at me like this shit's my fault. You were texting and talking at the same fucking time. What kind of law do you practice? You don't even fucking criminal? Criminal law. And are you a trial lawyer or are you? You're a trial lawyer. You're a trial lawyer and you don't even want to fucking admit to being a lawyer.
She told me not to.
She told you not to. She was probably just being like, shut the fuck up, it's gonna go bad. This girl's the smartest girl in here right now. And are you the one from Binghamton?
Yeah.
Now you can't fucking make fun of Binghamton anymore. Because she knew to keep her damn mouth shut. That is what they teach you in Binghamton. Where did you go to law medical school?
I went to Tulane.
You went to Tulane? Wait, why did you make it Tulane instead of Tulane? Isn't it Tulane? You say Tulane. Sounds like a fucking 4-lane highway in Atlanta. Because they whittle it down to a 2-lane. So you went there for 4 years where you got your law degree, which you don't want to admit to. Why? I still don't understand why not. Like, are you not proud of what you do?
I'm very proud.
You're very proud. Are you a defense attorney?
No.
No, you're a prosecutor.
Yes.
That's why you don't want to admit it, because you have a good job, but you make dick. That's why. You put criminals in jail and get paid $4.50 an hour to do it.
$8.75.
My apologies, doctor. So you've learned not to text during a show now, right? So I think we were talking about New Jersey.
Number 8, Heckler tries to lead a revolt.
What did you think when that guy was coming toward me? So we're performing in Full Circle Brewery in Fresno. And the thing that everybody would need to know to understand what happened is there was a taco truck outside that showed up right before the show started. And there was also a train that we could hear that kept passing through every so often.
Oh, there should not be kids in here. Aside from the fact that it's a comedy show, it's also a brewery. Let's just point that one out. Do those kids work here? Like that? What? They're with the taco truck, and they're gonna use the restroom right now. Okay, so they work for the taco truck. Well, Fresno, you were making quite an impression. This is the thing, like, I live in LA, and sometimes people talk shit about Fresno, and I was like, I'm gonna go up there, I'm gonna do an awesome show, I'm gonna come back down, I'm gonna tell all of them they're wrong. And now I'm like, I'm gonna go up there, I'm gonna do an awesome show, I'm gonna come back there, and then I'm gonna be like, some of you were correct. Some stuff that wasn't completely off, okay? Be like, did a lot of people come to the show? Be like, yeah, a whole train full. I went right by, actually. Oh my god, that is... Well, all those kids together add up to 21, so fuck it, let's do this. All right.
There's no way I can ignore what happened. But it's really the only thing I said about Fresno. Like, I pretty much ignored where we were, as weird as it was, except for that. And then during the close of the show, I did a joke about how Fresno was kind of in the middle of nowhere.
If you want the free stuff, I'll ask you for my email list. That way you find out the next time I'm ever doing a show in Fresno. Never passing through on my way to die in the wilderness. There ain't nothing else around here.
The brewery itself was kind of loud, so I didn't realize that there was chatter going on in the corner of the bar. Because, you know, there were kegs being moved, there were super high ceilings, and so there was no way for me to really understand, and I hate that this is the only word for it, what was brewing.
Going to San Francisco or Sacramento or whatever, and you're from LA, you go to 99, you just stop in Fresno, because that's your last shot. I gotta eat. Be like, let's stop in Fresno. We're good luck, motherfucker. Like, that's...
So overall, the show is great. And then as I'm closing, I notice this guy suddenly walking out. Now, I didn't think anything of it because at first I'm thinking, oh, he's just leaving. Maybe he doesn't like the show. Maybe he's got to get home for some reason. Not a big deal.
So here's what I want to do to close the show out here. I'm gonna let you guys participate.
Oh my God, this motherfucker's talking about Fresno. What up?
What?
Fresno's not a bad place. You're the bad dude. You think LA's all cool, dude.
Is that what happened?
Really? You're talking a lot of shit about Fresno.
I think you're bad at words.
I think you're bad at comedy.
Okay, well, you're in the minority.
My job ain't words, brother.
I love that he thought he was Norma Ray. Like leading the protest out the door. We should all leave, and then nobody left.
I didn't realize the mayor of Fresno was here.
If that guy had attacked me, would you have had my back?
I was gonna have to like Jeff Van Gundy it and just grab a body part and hang on, because I wasn't gonna stop him.
They definitely didn't know who they were coming to see. They were like, that was so amazing. He's like, you're fucking with Fresno! Like, the last joke I did was about how Fresno is where you stop because everything else sucks. And he's like, yeah, fuck Fresno. What? I don't like words. And then he goes, my job isn't words. I'm like, yeah, I got that. I picked up on that. I understand. It's loading and unloading. I get what your job is.
I think through most of it, I was more confused than anything. Like, I didn't even realize what was going on. Like, I wasn't scared at any point because it took me so long. By the time I figured out exactly what was happening, he was already leaving.
What kind of self-conscious mother is he? Is he on house arrest in Fresno? Can he not leave?
You're making fun of the one place that ever loved me. I got kicked out of Bakersfield.
Wayne walked out all puffed up too. That was amazing. He's like, my job isn't words. My job is nutritional supplements.
The thing that I dislike most about this guy is that it takes such an ego to watch 100 people having a good time with something and be like, this sucks, right, everybody? Like, it was a great show. We're all having a wonderful time. And he's like, I'm gonna lead you guys to freedom.
And I was like, Fresno can be a little weird. And he's like, fuck you, man! Traffic's terrible, there's pollution, and I'm fine with it because it's 72 and sunny all the time. So I deal with that shit, and that's okay. And he's like, this is the only place. Is he a regular here? Is he coming here a lot? No? Because he's probably not going to come back.
The entrance to the brewery are these glass doors that are stage left, and then there's this moment where everyone starts staring at the doors. And I had to try to figure out what was going on.
What? Is he gonna drive into the doors? What's happening? What? He just took the city bus? Are you fucking with me right now? Where is the city bus? short bus wouldn't have fit that steroided motherfucker. There's no way. By the way, I wouldn't say any of this to his face. He murdered me, so. He'll come back next year. I'm not here. It's just him sitting up here with a teardrop tattoo. That's what happened.
I think there's a moment in this clip where you can see that I knew that this was going to go viral.
So what I was going to say is that I've had a lovely time. Best part is, so for those of you who are very familiar with my work, you know that I kind of got popular from the Heckler clips online.
Yeah.
And so when people come to see that, like people come to see a show, and a lot of times it doesn't happen, because that only happens one out of every 10 or 15 times. So a lot of times people come to a show, and afterward they're like, oh, I wish that would have happened. And tonight, you got a live fucking show. So we're all part of that together.
So California's down on the Your Tour, and Texas is next, but you are not coming with us.
Thus ends the Danny Giles portion.
Thus ends the great Danny Giles experiment.
I feel good about it.
Crowds were great, though.
They were great. It was great shows. Everyone should go see the rest of it.
Yeah, it was packed out. We'll do Texas next.
Guys, go see it.
When am I coming back?
That guy's gone.
First, you guys need to walk me to my car. I'm coming back probably maybe next year. If we do this again, we'll be fine. By then, those kids will be grown. That guy will be driving the bus, you know?
I love Fresno.
He needs bumper stickers.
Oh, he's got bumper stickers.
You folks were a lot of fun. You really were, and it's a shame that that guy had to leave, because if he had left, like, he would have heard me at the end just be like, I had a wonderful time with my friends. But he'll have no idea. He'll just walk and be like, that guy fucking hates Fresno. He can watch himself on YouTube. That's going to be great. He has no internet connection. He can go to the public library, one of the many services offered in the city of Fresno.
I mean, this is almost too thrilling.
Number 7. Heckler accidentally cheers for the KKK. Number 6. Outdoor Heckler Gets Schooled.
Outdoor shows are hard. Daytime shows are harder. And outdoor daytime shows are next to impossible. But at Tallahassee Community College, I had a pretty good crowd of about 30 students gathered around the stage, and things were going well. After doing a joke about how no one should aspire to work at McDonald's, a student walked right up to the stage, gave me a bunch of weird hand signals, and then backed up into the crowd.
What's happening over there? You were giving me a signal before. The dude in the yellow, you were giving me a signal. You came over and gave me a hand signal. Okay. You just have headphones on. How are you watching a comedy show with headphones on? No, you will not get the mic. You're dumb enough to watch a comedy show with headphones. You think I'm going to give you the mic? Do you? This isn't how comedy works, man. You can't just, like, say a mean thing that makes no sense. No, no, that's not how it works. No, your school's paying me a lot of money to prevent you from doing things like this. Oh, do you see how everyone laughed when I said something and didn't when you said something? Because that's how this works. You have a good day, sir. Oh, man. I apologize for those McDonald's jokes. I didn't mean to offend you. Still wearing the uniform. I want to know, like, in his headphones, was he just listening to, like, a motivational tape before that happened? Was that just Eminem from 8 Mile? Just be like, you only got one shot. And then he did it, and his one shot did not work out in his favor. Oh, man. I'm okay with it. I only got another 10 minutes up here. You gotta be in class with him for 2 years, so.
Number 5, Heckler tries, that's what she said.
My point is you can learn from Twitter. You can. You just said that's what she said. Dude, you're not as clever as you think you are, and don't try again. That's what she said to what? You can learn from Twitter? Is that real sexual? You know, you can learn from Twitter. That's what she said, because she agrees with your viewpoints.
The reason I snapped at this guy when he interrupted is because he actually tried to mess with me before the show. I don't even think he knew I was the comedian, but as I was walking in, he comes over to me and he does the whole, hey, your shoelaces are untied thing. And I was like, I don't have shoelaces. And he said, well, your buttons are untied. And I was like, well, they're buttons. And he was like, but they're sewed on and the sewing is... And I was like, hey, look, man, I don't know what it is that you're trying to do, but it's not working, so have a good day. And I just walked in. He was wearing a multicolored bright fluorescent jacket. I think he just really wanted attention. Later on, I botched the setup to a joke, so I decided to have a little bit of fun with it.
Let me tell this the fucking right way. This is all wrong, and I'm very angry about it. That's what she said. Anyway, so...
The show got back on track, and I went into the Q&A.
What's with
your
pockets? What's with my pockets? Keys? My right one? It's bulging out. Oh, that's where I keep my dick, actually. That's where... It's right there. Which is weird, because I dress to the left, and it just kind of goes around, rolls up. Right there. That's my buddy. It's just the jeans are faded, because that's where I keep my wallet normally. So it works. So you don't have pockets, I don't think. You were just wearing shorts. Okay, you have stuff in your pockets, but it's shorts. What kind of material are they made of? Spandex. Yeah, that's why they don't, like, fade, because they're made out of bicycle shorts. But when you become an adult, you start wearing clothes.
How many kids do you want?
How many kids do I want? Like, to... Are you selling kids, man? Like, look, I got a truck in the back. I got a great deal.
Of course, he tried one more time.
Who else has quiet? Oh, neon guy who tried to interrupt before. What do you got?
How long does it take me to get ready?
How long does it take me to get ready? What? For what? For a show? Like, how long does it take me to get this vest on? It's not difficult. It's like a shirt with fewer buttons. It's actually... Well, if you're like Justin Bieber, that takes forever. But I'm not like Justin Bieber, and therefore... Is that your own, that's your only scale? How many Biebers does it take you to get ready in the morning? From one to Bieber, how long does it take? Just the B-I. Or is it the E first? I don't know. I before E, except after C, and different when you own a monkey. I don't know what the rhyme is. What do you got?
Steve, have you ever lost to a heckler?
Have I ever lost to a heckler? Well, you saw what happened earlier. No. Because the thing is, people who want to yell and interrupt, like, they don't know how to, they don't know what to do next. That's where it ends. Yeah, it sure does, see? Even he knows. That is where it ends, and that's what she said. So,
Well, at least he knew he was defeated. By the way, there is nothing wrong with wanting attention. Hell, I'm in a field where wanting attention is a requirement. The problem comes when you try to take it from other people. So, to Neon Guy, if you're watching, the way to get attention is not to fuck with strangers in a hallway or to interrupt a performance. It's to find what you love to do and get really fucking good at it. And then, you won't even need the fluorescent jacket.
Number 4. Same heckler won't shut up.
We got 8 U.S. presidents had right here. George Washington was the first one. But you can't picture it. Leprechaun. Do you really think I didn't write the end of this fucking joke? Do you really think I just wrote the beginning? I was like, oh, hope someone shouts out leprechauns, otherwise I'm fucked. I appreciate you playing the home version of stand-up comedy. Your consolation prize is to shut the fuck up for the rest of the show. All right.
I'm short, so. Get all fired up.
You get all fired. At this point, maybe we should all just fuck our cousins and get it out of the way.
Hell yeah!
I like most of you. Most of you.
We love you.
I appreciate that, sir. Hopefully not in a cousin sort of way, but... You're not fucking wasted. If you've been interrupting this show this whole fucking hour, you're not wasted. You're not wasted. Our time was wasted. Your education was wasted. And possibly your father's sperm and your mother's egg, those were wasted. Here's why you don't yell shit at a comedy show. Here's why. Here's why. Because we are funnier than you. And I don't mean to bruise egos. I'm not saying that to piss anyone off. It's a true fucking fact. That's why we do this for a living. I told someone that once, and he was pissed off. He was like, you're not funnier than me. I'm like, sir, I'm a professional comedian. Clearly, I'm funnier than you.
Because you're a douche.
I'm a what?
You're a feminine hygiene fella.
I told him he was right. I am a douche. I am. Because after I fucked his mom, she smelled better. You are a fucking dick. They don't want you to be talking.
Number 3. How not to act at a comedy club.
During a show at the Reno Tahoe Comedy Club, there were two women who were being really freaking loud. They were talking to each other, they were answering rhetorical questions, and just being a general nuisance. They interrupted 3 of the 4 opening acts. So during intermission, they were warned that if they interrupted again, that they would be asked to leave. They apologized, and promised that it would be the end of it. It was not the end of it.
Reno is such a crazy town, man.
Crazy!
Reno is nuts. It's nuts. First time I ever came here, I asked the same question I ask whenever I go to a new city. I said, what's the best thing to do here? So I was like, oh, you gotta go see Tahoe. And I was like, the best thing to do is leave? That's fucked up. Oh man, I love Seattle. Why? Portland? That's a different place. I was walking over here, because there was an early show, so it was still daylight and it was safe to walk. And so, I was walking over here, and there were these 2 girls sticking out of a sunroof of a car, like getting all, you know, excited, and they were drunk, but it wasn't a limo, it was like a 98 Hyundai, you know, just like it just had a sunroof, and they just jammed themselves through their shitty sunroof, and they're like, Reno! And I was like, that car should be the mascot of Reno, that is incredible. Reno! And then there was someone in front of me, walking down the street in front of me, and she goes, well, it's 5 o'clock somewhere. And I was like, first of all, it's 6:15. So it's not 5 o'clock anywhere. Second of all, that's what you say when someone's drunk during the day. That's what you say when someone's drunk before 5 o'clock. When they're drunk at like 1, you'd be like, well, it's 5 o'clock somewhere. But this was later than 5 o'clock. I was like, what kind of a shitty meth? Where the fuck am I? And then right then I see Reno, biggest little city in the world, so. Perfect. I want to tell you guys a story of how I became an optimist. Are you the one who's been talking the whole show? I'm just gonna give you a heads up. I'm not gonna kick you out, but you might kick you out. Monologue. So here's a story of how I became an optimist. So
I got back into material.
I had been telling a story about being an optimist that takes a lot of windy twists and turns. The two girls kept talking, although they were being a little quieter. Actually, I didn't even know it was two of them at the time, I thought it was just one. So when someone else in the front row quietly raised their hand, I used that as an opportunity to address the chatter. And when one of them denied ever talking, that was when I had enough.
Wait, you have a question? What is happening right now? So why am I an optimist? The story's not over yet. Holy shit, that's part of the whole fucking act? She's like, I don't understand why you seem very negative. I'm gonna get fucking be patient. What if I was just like, you know what? No, I'm not an optimist. I am an optimist because that woman shut the fuck up, so I'm feeling better. So, I don't even know if she's still here, but she's quiet, and that's good. We'll keep it that way. And I'll explain why I'm an optimist, but not for another 34 minutes. Woo! So Pete, what?
You're trying to egg her on, and that's not
helpful. No, I'm not.
Well, I'm just saying.
That's the problem. It's my turn to say. For another 34 minutes. You're probably not gonna hear the end of the story.
Well, I'm down to listen.
Okay. I don't know if you know, but you're listening with the wrong hole. This one. This is the hole you listen with. This is the hole you talk with. Not as much of an optimist as I was a minute ago. Any other time, if there was any other show where someone in the middle of a bit raised their hand and interrupted me, I'd have been upset at that person. You're a fucking angel, lady. You're an angel. Because you were very polite about it. You're like, I have a thought, and so I'm just gonna, I would like to, it is up to him to call on me or not. I'll just raise my hand and politely ask. I don't mean to interrupt, sir, but I'm very concerned. Meanwhile, hold on. All right, we're gonna get back into this for a second.
Asked to leave, and I didn't say a word. Right on, guys. You did awesome. Don't worry. We will never tell any of our friends to come to.
Oh, you don't have friends.
We have a lot.
You do, but you're not gonna remember this tomorrow, so it's okay. Actually, you will. Do you remember the part where you did say words? Because you just said a second ago that you're being asked to leave for not saying anything. There's both of you talking. I don't give a fuck which one of you interrupted.
Exactly, because you're fucking retarded.
Oh, that's so sensitive of you.
I know. I have a big heart.
You have a big heart. That's not what's big on you. Shut the fuck up and leave. Remember when I warned you, when I politely was like, hey, this is gonna stop now and you might kick yourself out? That's because this has happened before. I don't care which one of you started interrupting.
I have 103.5 at my job every Thursday that gives away the
Just need to take a quick break for a second to tell you that after the show, I looked it up, and there is no 103.5 in Reno. Seriously, that radio station doesn't exist. They just made it up.
There are 30 people that don't give a fuck. Have a great night, ladies.
30 people? Why, that's all of Reno. By the way, I love that. Be like, we're going to tell everyone. I'm taping this show. Shut the fuck up. We can show them. I have three angles of you not shutting the fuck up.
Fuck you, you fucking loser.
Oh, you're so classy. So to answer your question about being out, you know what my favorite thing about that shit is? The idea of like, we didn't do shit even though four of the comics told us to shut the fuck up. We didn't do anything. We're gonna tell everybody at our job that we may or may not have tomorrow. I don't believe they work. I started nice. Because here's what happened. They yelled out during Camilla's set, and I don't give a fuck which one of Tweedledee and Tweedledum yelled. I don't care. I believe they yelled out during Drew's set. They yelled out during Sam's set. I think Verma was actually the only one they didn't yell during, because I think that they're so intolerant that they saw Verma and they're like, we don't know how to handle this, you know? So, and then toward the beginning of my set, they were fucking Chatty Cathy's again. And I was like, hey, please stop this, because there are other people who paid to see a show. And they were like, we don't know where we are. And they're like, tomorrow, we're gonna give the Circus a terrible review. Like, they have internet. Anyway, so. I love, they're getting tossed out of a comedy show and they called me a loser. You know how big of a loser you have to be tossed out of a show? Do you think those two were mad about the Hyundai joke? Is that why they were so pissed off? They were like, we were happy to get out of the sunroof. What I need from you guys is you guys need to counteract the bullshit one-star reviews they're gonna give tomorrow. So what I request from you guys is you guys go online and five-star the fuck out of this place so those two idiots are inconsequential, okay? So you don't have, they don't have internet. Yeah, but I'm sure their dealer does. So I...
Number two. Heckler thinks it's her show.
During Jarrett Bernstein's set in Seattle, he did a joke about breaking up with a woman named Rachel. And so, someone in the crowd ruined the joke by making it about them.
Go to a party, be like, check it out, this is my new girlfriend, Rachel. She's twice as fast as Karen. Thank you for ruining my joke, Rachel. What the fuck? That is a classic Rachel move. That is exactly why we broke up, Rachel. Unbelievable. Rachel's, man. I'm gonna change that joke now too. This is my new girlfriend, Stacy. She shuts the fuck up, unlike Rachel. Jesus.
She was quiet the rest of the show until I started setting up the Q&A.
And so what I want to do is I've been talking at you the whole show, and now I want to give you a chance to participate.
We're
some of you
tried
to fucking wait. What did you yell already? You said you're not allowed to hackle. That's not what the word is. Funny, because my hackles are up right now. Hackle is a word like it's like a part of a dog. You're from the East Coast, you say hackle. I'm from New York, motherfucker. No, we don't. Are you correcting me on comedy terminology? What do you do for a living? Nothing? That would have been my guess. So, what do you do for, are you Rachel?
I'm Rachel.
Yeah, no shit. I was backstage when that shit happened. But I'm like, what are the odds? We got two people who don't know when to shut the fuck up. What are the odds? What do you do for a living, Rachel?
I train dressage horses.
You what? You train horses. You train dressage horses.
That's why I'm loud.
Yeah, that's why you're loud. Because you have to talk to horses. By the way, on the East Coast, we say dressage. Oh, no, we don't, because that's your fucking business, so you know how to pronounce the goddamn word. You train dressage horses. No, that's very important, that in this time in our economy, I can think of no more valuable job than to train show horses for the rich. I can think... No, that's true, because when the rest of us are eating soup out of boots, it's very important that rich people still have their fucking horses. What?
Use dressage boots.
For a suit pot. I know what a horseshoe is. It's not hollow. What? The boots on your feet. For the soup. No, I appreciate you correcting the joke. I'm missing the joke. Yeah, that's what happened. Rachel, what part of the East Coast are you from? What? What part of the East Coast are you from?
Outside New York.
Outside New York. Well, that's where we are right now. I'm from inside New York. Everyone who's not where, from where I'm from is from outside New York. What? What?
You say heckle, I say hackle.
I say heckle, you say hackle. Yes, because you're wrong. What part of outside New York should I just start bidding with states? Pennsylvania.
Everybody raise their hands when he says the state.
Everybody raise their hand when you say the state. No, no, no. I'm not asking for state pride. I'm trying to get you to answer a fucking question. Where did you get mail growing up? What?
Pittsburgh.
So I said Pennsylvania. You said outside New York and it's Pittsburgh? That's a 6-hour fucking drive. Where are you from? Outside Washington. What part? Alaska. What the fuck? Just curious. Just curious. How many people here are from Philly? Any Philly people? Or Connecticut?
Yeah.
Got a couple? Okay, I'm just trying to find all the people who live much closer to New York than you do. So you're saying in Pittsburgh, they say, and by the way, what part of Pittsburgh? Within city limits or outside?
Within
city limits. I'm just making sure, because at this point, I have no idea. Be like, oh, I'm from Pittsburgh. What part? Ohio? Fuck. It's getting closer and closer to Washington. Well, Rachel.
Yes, Steve.
By the way, I know no one else's name in this crowd. There's a reason for that. Mine's on the fucking wall, which is why you know mine. I know yours because of earlier.
Yeah.
Rachel.
Yes, Steve.
Heckling means interrupting someone when they're in the middle of something. Which is what you're not supposed to do, especially while I'm talking about crowd participation. It's literally the last part of the show where you're not allowed to interrupt, and you're like, let me interrupt to tell you that we're not allowed to interrupt. That is amazing. Like, that's like smashing into someone's car to tell them their brake light is out. Yeah, now it is, because you just fucking destroyed my car. Okay. So we're getting to the crowd participation part of the show, or, for those of you from Pittsburgh, the crude participation of the show. Because apparently vowels have no meaning in Pittsburgh. I know a lot of people from Pittsburgh. I'm gonna ask every single fucking one of them whether or not they say hackle, and they will all be like, ugh, you met Rachel, did you? Rachel, who'd you come here with? Who are your friends here? All these silent people shaking their heads. Rachel, are you familiar with my YouTube?
No.
No? You're gonna be.
And then I finally got the Q&A.
Right? Yes.
Yes.
So, do you ever get weird out when you think about like how many people watch your videos and take them out?
Do I ever get weirded out? Wait, let me repeat this for anyone who thought they must have misheard. Do I ever get weirded out when I think of all the people who watch my videos while taking a dump? Not till now. But also, now I know how you watch my videos. I never thought of it that way, but you know what? Maybe I'm easing their pain. You know, maybe someone's having a rough one. And I can help them laugh through it. Maybe my videos can act as a laxative. I don't know. Did I move to the West Coast after meeting people like Rachel on the East Coast? No, because Rachel lives in the Midwest. Because that's where the fuck Pittsburgh is. Because I've traveled. How many hurricanes have you had to deal with? in Pittsburgh. Because it's not on the fucking East Coast. So none. None. It's just amazing to me. No one from Boise is like, West Coast, motherfucker!
Jarrett really did change the name of the person in the joke. When he tells it now, her name is Stacy. Take that, Rachel. Sorry, Rachel.
And the number one dumb heckler, Nazi heckler, walks out.
In Santa Barbara, I had done a joke about how it's the crowd's responsibility to know something about the comedian they're coming to see, since we don't buy tickets to see the crowd. Then, I was working on a new bit that makes fun of Nazis. I am leaving this material in the clip unedited, so you can see just how many times this woman interrupted me. And also, so you can see that I didn't say anything offensive to anyone, except Nazis.
Nazis are the fucking problem right now, which is such a weird thing to have to say in my lifetime. I didn't think I would ever have to say, and by the way, I know you have opinions on the joke, but you could talk to me after the show. So, no, because Nazis, how could Nazis be a problem? Like, how could that be a sentence I have to say unless I was summarizing Raiders of the Lost Ark? Like, that would make sense if someone's like, hey, you summarized Raiders of the Lost Ark? I'd have been like, Nazis are the fucking problem. Like, that is what the movie's about. You're exactly right. They marched in Charlottesville and said shit. They said, Jews will not replace us. I'm Jewish, and when I heard that, I thought it was so funny, and here's why. I wasn't offended. How could you be offended at something that fucking dumb? Yeah. It's so dumb. If your life is such a piece of shit that you need to blame another group for your own problems, no one wants to replace you. They don't have to worry about Jews coming for them. Maybe self-checkout scanners at Walmart, those are coming. Those are real. Those appear. They should protest those. Stand outside Walmart with a tiki torch they bought from that same Walmart. Just have to scan it in themselves. Just the ultimate indignity, but they know how to do it because they used to work there, you know? Try to punch in the skew and it's not coming up. And they're like, come on, skews will not replace us, you know? I think it's amazing what people try to blame on Jewish people. Like, Vladimir Putin said that Jews fixed the election for Trump. And a whole bunch of people on Twitter were like, yeah, that's what happened. Jews fixed the election for Trump. For Trump? Are you fucking stupid? Jews fixed the election for Trump. For Trump. Not Bernie, but Trump. Really. Not the one time we've ever had a shot at the presidency, we fixed it for the other guy? Are you fucking kidding me? The only way I believe that Jews fixed the... Fuck off! Okay. Let me finish my fucking thought. Like I said, I didn't buy a ticket to see you. Okay, so. But let's explore your point. What was it that you thought was so important? What do you say? What?
I couldn't see her leave because she was sitting in the darkness, so it took me a second to figure out what was going on.
She left. She was straight up offended that I was making fun of Nazis.
Yes.
That is amazing. Yeah. Oh man, I liked it better when they wore pillowcases.
Yeah.
Was she mad that I like yelled at her to stop interrupting?
You told her to fuck off.
I told her to fuck off and she was like, oh, good idea. I haven't thought of that as an option.
I already finished.
That was actually the easiest, like, heckle stop that's ever happened. I was like, fuck off! She's like, okay, and just left. I gotta be more direct, more obvious. I've never had anybody, like, leave during the Nazi bit. I'm surprised I didn't see her leave. I would have thought I would have heard the boots. I'm still laughing at the fact that lady was just like, and then left. Because what she said, I think she said something about like Trump's support of Israel, and that's why Jews would have fixed the election for him.
What?
Which is the, but yeah, because I heard a little bit of it, and part of why I steamrolled it is because I was like, what a weird thing, what a hill to die on right now, in the middle of a comedy show. So be like, I know you're telling jokes, but let's discuss the Palestine-Israel conflict. I think that'll really help us here. We've all gotten our drinks. I think that's going to help this discussion as well.
this couldn't possibly go bad. And then I was like, fuck off. And she's like, yeah, that's probably a better idea. I'm gonna go.
And then during the Q&A, someone sitting next to the camera asked about it.
How much do I get paid for being your cameraman?
How much do you get paid for being my cameraman? You're not my cameraman, you're just not knocking it over. And by the way, please don't, because that clip, I'm gonna need that clip from earlier. That clip's gonna get 1 million views. Nazi heckler walks out, are you fucking kidding me?
Do you think I missed any? You can add them in the comments. And if you want to see the full video version of any of these, they're in the description, as is the link to Audible. Thanks again for helping me afford this badass set.